Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today is the video that I talked about in the last video that I posted. That was a big deal. Big things were gonna happen, and I've got something very cool for you guys today. So I've got this right here, and this thing is heavy. You guys probably know what this is from the title already. So I've never opened this yet. So this is going to be my first impression. But here we go. Big Boy, Union Pacific Big Boy, 4014, Paragon 3, Sound DCC, HO Scale, Broadway Limited, Paragon 3 and everything. And in front of us, we have here a map of the Cumbres and Toltec Scenic Railroad, just because I needed something white. I'm going to start having something like this as kind of like the background, so that it kind of makes my crappy lighting whenever I'm doing reviews a little bit, you know, less crappy. So I've never opened this yet. I've been waiting for this for 2 weeks, so we're just gonna open this, and let's get right into it. Set that back there. Alright, let me reposition this a little bit so you guys are getting a little bit, okay, that's probably good. Okay, so, we've got here, owner's manual, the special features list. Listed some special features. Exploded parts diagram for locomotive and tender. And the Broadway Limited's 1 year warranty. Looks like that 2 year warranty they had is no longer existent. Okay, let's get to the thing itself. Oh man. Okay, so we got some stuff to remove here. And I'm just going to get it out of the box first, and then we're going to take a look at it here. How do I even get it out of the box? Oh man, this thing is huge. Alright, I'm just going to get it out of the box here. This thing is much bigger than I thought it was. Oh man, let's see. Oh man, this thing is like as long as my arm. Oh my gosh, what? Shut up, phone. Battery's low. Okay, good to know. Have to charge my phone in a second. Let's see. Also in the box we have a hood, smoke box or smokestack hood. Or deflector or whatever it is. We got traction tires and a tool. I'm stepping on the leg of the tripod. Oops. We've got a funnel for smoke. For the smoke fluid. And we have, looks like a front coupler. So I'm gonna go ahead and get all of the like packaging and all that stuff off of this thing. And we're going to take a look at that in just a second. Okay, guys, so the first thing we're going to take a look at is the tender. I've got my toothpick here. Oh, that shows up nicely. Toothpick here. So we're going to look at the details of the tender. Union Pacific. Nice and legible. Very nice. You've got handrails up on the top, your water hatches and oil hatch. Because I have 4014, this is the one that it's the one that's like oil burning and stuff. So that they're restoring stuff. So you got all these little details up here. I'm assuming are some sort of like water gauge or not oil gauges and whatnot. Most Union Pacific steam locomotives have like white caps on the ends or on the trucks of the tenders, and they didn't do that on this. I'm not sure if that's just because it isn't going to be on 4014 whenever it gets restored, finally, or if they just, you know, left it off. You got ladders, pretty sturdy. Moving to the back, we have marker lights, I think, backup light. I think that's LED. You got your coupler, UP4014. I don't know what that is. I think it's like a marker light or a backup light or something like that. Coupler cut lever. I think that's a glad hand right there. And stuff is a little bit difficult to see on camera, and it's definitely difficult to see on camera the enormousness of this locomotive. It is absolutely huge, and I'm gonna get one of our other ones here in a bit and do a bit of a comparison. Let's see, other side, same, just about the same thing as the first side, and then on the front of the tender here, you got your whatever, drawbar, whatever that is, the connection point. You've got your pin connection down here, ladders, handrails, piping, all sorts of cool details. And it's super detailed and super good looking. So yeah. Now, I'm trying to find a way to get it brighter, but it's just not going. I need a better light, I think. Let's see if I can get this closer, maybe. I'm fighting the lighting right now, so yeah. Okay, we're gonna move this back. I'll edit that out. I'm gonna move this back and take a look at the locomotive itself, which I'm gonna kinda move around, to show you guys properly. Okay, guys, so this locomotive is so big and has so much... This locomotive is so big and has such detail that I really can't cover it all. No one can possibly cover it all. But, I'm gonna try to do something. Let me move the light. Oh, that's a bit better. I'm gonna try to do something here, so... let's see. You got your headlight, Union Pacific, I don't know if that's kind of loud right in your face there, but Union Pacific shield, lighted number boards, a bell that does in fact move around. You got your cow catcher here. Well, some people call it a cow catcher, some people don't. And this can be flipped around. You can put a coupler in there instead. That assembly was in a bag over there. You got your deck plating, safety tread, classification lights. Moving down to the side, you have your valve gear detail down here, all nice and stuff. You have your, looks like it might be a builder's plate right there. You got your whistle. Smokestacks, of course. Various detail. Pretty sturdy handrail. All of this piping down here as well. You got all sorts of stuff. Oh, man. Moving farther down the side to the second set of drivers. You've got various things up here. Nice brass colored. More side valve gear detail. I don't know what that is. Safety tread on all the walkways and stuff. Plenty of sturdy handrails. You got, I believe this is the dynamo here, and I think on the actual on the prototype, it's a double dynamo or something like that. Can't quite remember, but I don't know. You've got rivet detail on your firebox down here, which is absolutely massive. Moving to the cab. Adjust my light again. Get it as best as I can onto the cab. I'm fighting this right now really bad. Okay. I think that's good. Okay. Moving on to the cab, you got cab figures installed. Let's see. Windows do open and close. You've got a roof hatch kind of tight. Roof hatch does open. There you go. And stuff. And of course, plenty of like piping and detail here. On the back of the cab, you've got like door and window and stuff here, and you got the plug for the that goes to the tenders actually in the locomotive. Let me adjust my camera. Actually, it's actually on the locomotive. You got a nice deck plate there. Let's see, on the other side, you just got another cab figure windows open and close on this one as well. You can like get a toothpick, or you can do it with your finger. But it kind of leaves a bit of a thumbprint on the window. And then you basically got about the same stuff. You just got like some of that stuff that's on. Oops, I bumped the camera. You got some of that stuff that's on one side and isn't on the other. And yeah, so that is that's the locomotive there. And now we're gonna take it over to the layout, and I'm gonna run through the sound functions and operation and stuff like that. So I'll see you guys in just a second. And we'll be over at the layout, see how it operates. Okay, guys. So we've got it here. I haven't applied track power yet. I wanted to do that on camera. Because, dude, this thing. Haven't applied track power yet. I'm going to apply track power now. You can see the number board lights and classification lights and stuff come on. And this thing also has a light in the cab whenever it is not moving. Okay, so the default address of this is, of course, set to 3. So, let's move it a little bit to get it going. Hope you guys can hear that good. Okay. Just gonna let it warm up a little bit more, get going. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it's starting to smoke a little bit. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and run down the list of functions for this thing now. So F0. That's F11. Oops, that's the wrong button. F0 is the headlight. Gonna do some stuff here for a second. F0 is the headlight. F1 is the bell. F2 F2 is the whistle. Now, this is the new one, and this comes with an incredible feature. Before I do the whistle, I just want to inform you guys. I don't know if you guys know about this, but whenever you blow the whistle, smoke will come out. So, smoke comes out of the whistle in this. So, here's the whistle. Oh, that's awesome. Oh, that is awesome. It is so thick. I love it when the smoke is thick. On a lot of engines, I'm just going to move all that away here. On a lot of locomotives, that's just not very thick. The smoke is not very thick. And this is, it's thick smoke. That's good. Okay, F3 is the coupler slack. F4 is the air pump. F5 is when stopped, it does a blowdown. But when moving, it's increased chuff intensity. F6 is water fill, but I'm sure you guys have heard that before. Ignore that. I'm sure you guys have heard that before, so for the sake of time, we're just not going to do that one. F7 is smoke on and off. I haven't pressed F7, and it's on, so hey. F8 is mute. F9 is startup and shutdown, which I'm not going to do right now. F10 is coal shovel or auger. And as this is an oil-burning locomotive, it does not, you don't have that. I'm going to actually do something real quick. You just switch the switch. Okay. F11 is the water injectors. F12 is brake set / brake release, and when moving, it brake squeal. Okay, so, and then there's a bunch of other functions, but my Digitrax remote only goes up to F12, so that's nice. Anyway. So we're going to go ahead and check the speed next. So we're going to get it going here. Do speed up to speed step 4. It's such a big locomotive. We're just going to do it up to speed step 4. Okay. Speed step 1. A little bit of a weirdness is 2, 3. That's weird. 3. I'll go ahead and go to 5. It's a little bit weird. Sometimes I think it's just because it's super new and hasn't been around yet, pretty much. Okay, backing up. Speed step 1. I'll go ahead and go to 2 to make sure it's not going to be weird. 3. And 5. Now, I expected this. I expected it to kind of be a bit jerky and kind of eh. It is a brand new locomotive, so There's always a possibility with a brand new locomotive that it's going to be kind of jerky and stuff. So, yeah, that is actually kind of it. I don't have a coupler gauge to check coupler height. I don't have a pull test thing. I don't have a decent scale that I know of. So I need to get those things, but this thing weighs a lot. I'm just going to tell you that. This thing's heavy. So also, another thing I don't have, Union Pacific passenger cars. So, I'm going to go ahead and this is going to be it. I'm going to leave you guys with a run-by. First, let's see, what was it? I'm going to mute him for a second. Okay, so some final thoughts. Overall, I'd say this thing is awesome. Absolutely huge. I love the thickness of the smoke. That's always a big problem with the locomotives we have. The smoke is not very thick. And it's difficult to see. You will never have problems seeing smoke with this thing, definitely on camera. It is a very good locomotive, absolutely huge. One thing I have not checked yet, I'm going to go ahead and check real quick and then come back to you after I'm like at the very end of the final thoughts here, because it's something that I have to send it around the line once so that I can see, you know, can it make my curves. It says 18-inch radius curve or greater, and I have locomotives that are definitely, like, they'll be able to do that, but nothing smaller. So, if, it should be able to make it. We'll see how it goes, but some spots in my curves aren't exactly right, so we'll just have to see how it goes. Anyway, I'm going to check that really quick, and I'll get back to you in just a second, give you my final thoughts, and then I will leave you guys with a run-by. So I'm going to see you in just a second. Okay, guys, so final thoughts. This thing does make it around my track. So that is awesome. Final thoughts. Now, I don't have any Union Pacific passenger cars yet. I will. I just have to get them first. I was looking for some the day I found out that this thing had come in. I had thought that they were going to come in about a month later than they did. So I got, I thought I had plenty of time and stuff, and then boom, this thing shows up. I'm not prepared. I don't have Union Pacific passenger cars, which is what I wanted to do the run-by with. Instead, what I'm going to do for you guys is I'm going to pull out some of my Santa Fe passenger cars and run them behind this. I really wanted to do it with Union Pacific passenger cars. The fact is, I just don't have any right now. I am going to be getting some as soon as I can. Getting some passenger cars for this thing. Because, dude, it's awesome. So, I'm going to grab the Santa Fe passenger cars, and I'm going to have to run it, do a run-by with that. But, overall, beautiful locomotive. It smokes like a beauty. And it is the coolest thing to watch this thing come out of a tunnel. Let me tell you, it is the coolest thing I've ever seen. The best tunnel exit I have ever seen of this thing. Or of any locomotive. Because the smoke is so thick, the smoke comes out before the locomotive. It's really cool. And I'm not going to show you guys in the run-by, because I want to show you guys this in an area of scenery that I have been working on and is a lot better looking. So I'm going to go ahead and get the Santa Fe passenger cars and hook them up to this thing. And I will see you guys next time. Enjoy the run by. If you are not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so for weekly railroading videos. Thank you guys, and I love this locomotive. But we'll see you next time. Bye.